Hello everyone, welcome to a new series on the channel. A series that, I will be honest, I didn't expect to be able to do. Metroid Prime, the remastered version on the Switch. Now, I gotta admit, it's been a long, long time since I 100% this game. I think the last time I did was... Oh boy, I think this actually was 10 years ago. Oh, thinking back on it. That's what I'm saying, I haven't played this game recently. I played the 3 maps to see how it looks in. Oh! Honestly, it's so good. It's got everything. Does it have small problems? Yeah, but that's more because it's Metroid Prime. Metroid Prime still has some issues. But before we go on, let's go to extras. Oh, it's not extras. It's options. What am I doing? Options. Sound. I don't change the opacity because it's fine. Health is nice, but I like the option of it coming off. But like, I do like that it does have that. I'm keeping the hints on because it has been a while, even though I did play it to being it. But this, I love this. I can change the color assist. I don't need to, but if I feel like I need to, I can turn it on. This is helpful. This is something that all games need. As well as, a different voice lighter and a toggle for seizure. Toggles don't have it be something that is on all the time. Controls! I'll go through each of the control schemes as we go through, but I will be playing mostly dual stick. I will switch the pointer at times. Well, it's been a while since I tried hybrid as well, so I might also. But I'll be giving all their dues and tell you the rough controls of them. So, yeah. This is my time, and this was my completion rating, 71%. I got all the energy tanks, so at least there's this one positive. I will get all the energy tanks. Unless I forget where one is. That is entirely possible. I hope that does not end up happening, but it is entirely possible to happen. Identified distress beacon as we track to a derelict space vessel in orbit above Talon 4.
The cosmos. In the vast universe, the history of humanity is but a flash of light from a lone star. The life of a single person should be lost in space and time. But among the stars, there is one light that burns brighter than all others. The light of Samus Aran. Her battles extend beyond her life and etch themselves into history. Here, another chapter of that history will be written.
Baddest bounty hunter herself, Samus Aran. We've got our HUD. We have two visors. Our scan visor, which is only in Prime. Our no combat visor. We switch them via the D-pad. And we move with the left stick and look around with the right stick. We fire with the A button. We jump with B. Nothing happens with X for now, but you can see in the bottom right, it's got something to do with the cannon. Pressing Y allows us to go into Morphle, X is jump, and I don't know why it's not B. But I sort of know why it's not B, it's because B does something else. A allows lower bombs, R fires missiles. ZR is also firing, ZL is locked on targets, L is jump as well, and I don't know why, and that is for the dual stick controls. Let's go to options, and go to controls, and switch to pointer. Oh, you can just use the controls here. Reset the gyro, pause, oh, they did not change. What's worse is that they fixed a different issue. Oh, spoilers, but they didn't fix this. They should have. Huh. Show morph ball controls. And they... Okay, thanks for spoiling that again. My god. Oh yeah, the spring ball is what it's called, not jump. But I will... Yep, motion controls, which you'd think would be bad. It's not. It's actually pretty fine. My only problem is with the morph ball. Also, because I'm not using the usual controls, it's different. Yeah, we already have grapples right now, so I'm fine with that being spoiled because it doesn't change anything. I don't think anything changed. Oh yeah, the only difference is spring balls on the gyros here, because spring ball never existed. And we can't look around. And also, scans on the left, and I don't get that. If you want my opinion on this, this is the worst control scheme. Don't use it unless you're playing on the actual GameCube. So here's the controls. Charge combo, which we will get to later. Oh no. Oh no, you really didn't fix this! Oh, I've spoiled everything that we're getting. Oh, there I go, trying to. Powerbomb. Yeah. And this is the... And I kind of like this... This? Wait, did I not actually put on? Oh, it's a hybrid of all of them. That's why I don't use it. Ah. Yeah, but I'm sticking with this for a while. For some bosses, I will switch to pointer because pointer is better for certain bosses. Oh, wait. Yeah. Oh, scan these things. I don't want to do that. I want to scan this. Why does this need to scan? There it is. Oh yeah, no, these. I'm not gonna waste missiles, which is weird considering I did waste one. We don't need to scan all these, and I won't be going for all scans. Except for all boss scans. I am going to go through all boss scans and all try and go for as many chosen lore, but I'm not going to go for every scan. Of course, certain scans are required. So we need to do this. Scan everything here because other than that, parasite. Wait. I do want to scan this though. Find out is the frigate Orpheon. So I don't believe the game tells us this unless we scan some data, which I will for this area, because otherwise you don't know anything about the ship. The game doesn't tell you it's the frigate Orpheon. Also, parasite queens. Now we know where those parasites come from. Scanning this. It's a platform. Thankfully, elevators are safe. at least in this game, I believe one of the later games is a bit mean. And there's one thing that is really mean about the game. Morphology unknown. Phase off. Stations. are unique. Not only do they save, they heal us. But we only heal when we're saving. But we don't get our ammo back, so be careful. Parasite Queen. Scanning. The Parasite Queen. Parasite female genetically enhanced by unknown means. We spot out the digit in the switch's mouth. Use your auto-target targeting to acquire a visible target. You can scan the cape in the presence of the creature. Origins unknown. Creature says that it will inspire with great blast of energy from its mouth. Great not present in the standard Parasite genome. The pirates have begun bioengineering program with considerable results. Yep, the mouth is the target. So you probably recognize, well, its original form, not only in Prime 1, but also in Smash Bros. Thank you. actually seen someone die to this. To the parasite. Granted, it was after a botched parasite queen fight, but still. Okay. We're almost out. Boss is gonna bear with us. Actually makes him just kind of a bit more scarier in my opinion. Save because we landed on Talon 4. There's many doors, but we can only go through this one here. There's one down there, there's one up there. Well, technically, we can reach the one up there, but I don't know if we can do anything about it. Let's see, actually. If we can, that'll be a good place to stop. Okay, if we can, I thought we had to wait until we got our whatever upgrade. Right. These tangleweeds are going to be the one thing you hate. Anyways. Yeah, this place is a cutscene because it's... I'm going to spoil it. This is technically the final area. But we don't get into any enemies here.
Recorded to logbook.
Age of design. Slideshow of the structure projects a containment field. This field bars access to a prime source of energy within a deep crater. Science team believes the field is powered by a number of strange chosen artifacts. We have found some of these relics. Studies on them have begun, as this field could hinder future energy production research production operations on Talon 4. We must dismantle it as soon as possible if this meets the chosen artifacts. It will be done. So, the space pirates are actually here. But we can't go any further, actually, because the blast shield. Come on, boss. Okay. Real soon. That's what I was thinking. I was like, I thought I needed a missile. Yeah, we do. Alright. Pirate scan our ship. Registered to Samus Aran. Charge your ship to recharge your energy. Reload your weapons and see progress in game. This ship is the only way to reload all your weapons. There are areas where you can reload your... What was that? I did press the jump button. Spoiled it, and I also technically spoiled it because I showed it. This is the only way to replenish power bombs. There are missile recharge stations around this planet. Well, I say stations, but I believe there's only like two in this entire game. I may be wrong, and I may have just missed them because, again, 71%. But, with that, next time on Metroid Prime Remastered, we're going to explore Talon 4 and hopefully get back at least one of our equipment, hopefully all of them eventually. Seriously, we'll be needing them. Xenozuma signing out.